Thank you very much for this great opportunity. Today I'm going to talk about how to handle your boss. It seems quite difficult, but believe me, your boss is also a human being. So what you have to do, that first you have to understand as a human being that what kind of qualities your boss may have. He may be tough, he may be emotional, he may be, you can say that, work alcoholic. He may be uber smart. He may be favoring somebody. So if you'll start writing something about your boss, you'll find variety of the things. But I'm not getting into all those things, that because these things are somehow will drag you in a negative direction. And you cannot change your boss, that's for sure. You have to survive with your boss. And end of the day, he is only responsible. So somehow he may be having some of the element or some of the talent. Because of that, he became your boss. So you have to respect his talent as well. Now question arises that how to manage. Because sometimes if bosses are too micromanaging people, and because of that, every time they are bringing some one or other mistakes. And it makes other person puzzled. Sometimes employees are losing their confidence. And sometimes they want to leave the company. But how many times you are going to leave the company? And company doesn't belong. And that company which doesn't belong to your boss. He's also an employee over there. But somehow he may be having an impression that he is the boss. So he's the owner of the company. Because nobody has told him before that. Boss, nothing is permanent in this world. And most of the time when appraisals are going on, and during the appraisal when bosses are not giving good remarks, on that time we realize it very closely that my boss doesn't like me, or my future has been completely devastated by my boss. But don't worry, if nothing is permanent, means this job is also not permanent. You have every right to go and search new jobs. Your boss is also not permanent. He may also change the job, or he may also be replaced by somebody else. So anything can happen. And most of the time we take decision with the last hope, like nothing is going to get changed. So have a faith and just try to understand your boss first as a human being. What are the constraints he is facing? What are the personal problems he may be facing? Where you can be, you can really help your boss by understanding his situations. If he is trying to, take the advantage of the situations, yes, he should be smart enough to handle the situation. You should be having good relation with the upper managements, like HR managers or senior managers. Or sometimes you can take the help of mentors. Yeah, how to handle your boss. Rather than having a head-on collision with your boss, fighting with your boss, or having dissatisfaction with your boss. You cannot survive. And believe me, 80% of the time in a company, whenever you are going every morning, you are thinking about your boss, that whatever you are doing, and out of that end of the day, how your boss is going to respond out of this responsibility of this given work. And sometimes we treat it as a fear. If something is not happening, boss is going to fire. It's not possible for bosses as well. They are also attached with the certain rules and regulations. So sometimes if that kind of bosses are there who thinks that this company belongs to them, have the different kind of treatment for them. Always get instructions through mail only. Never rely on their words. And if even though they are saying something verbal to do something, which you feel that it's not good, or he may take advantage out of this, after doing that activity, do report through mail only with photographs. Ki boss, as per your instructions, these are the works which I have completed. Thank you very much. So everything should be recorded because it's a company, it's not your personal work. So whenever he is saying or she is saying something that whatever I said you haven't done, or you haven't done it completely or in that manner what is exactly it was required. So now you have a data, and whenever you are sitting for appraisal, take all the printouts, all the data of your KPIs. KPI means what you call key KPI, like whatever you can say. I'm not able to recall after a long time. So you can understand that what exactly you have to do, right? Thank you very much. I think it's too long video. I want to talk a little bit more, but I can understand you will not like to listen this much. Yeah. So thank you very much for this great opportunity once again, and take care of yourself and your family. And thank you very much for your careful listening. Thank you.